This is not a map. It's not a satellite image either. Instead, it's a visualization of a myriad of ship positions, a snapshot of how 80% of the goods we consume every day got from where they were made to where you bought them. My name is Diego Sardeiro, and I am an economist at the IMF's Asia-Pacific Department.
And I am András Komáromi. I am an economist at the IMF's Institute for Capacity Development. We are here to explain how the data behind this visualization can inform policymakers who must respond to price increases that are partly fueled by supply bottlenecks.
Few of us ever thought much about supply chains before the pandemic, as it usually happens with things that operate smoothly behind the scenes. But for us, as economists, it's part of our job. Unfortunately, it is difficult to track most supply chain developments in real time.
Some time ago, with our co-authors Yang Liu and Mamoun Said, we embarked on a project to do just that for the case of seaborne trade. For safety purposes, cargo ships carry a device that periodically emits a radio signal that can be picked up by satellites or terrestrial stations. These signals include useful information about the ships, such as their position, speed, and how deep they are into the water.
We use different machine learning algorithms to transform these messages into estimated trade volumes for each ship, for each voyage. Just to give you an idea of how much data that is, we're sifting through over 2 billion radio messages to produce these estimates.
Our monitoring system proved useful to track the sudden drop and swift recovery in trade during the early stages of the pandemic. More recently, however, a different type of question emerged, one that provided an unexpected new application for our maritime trade estimates.
As policymakers were discussing the potential shape of post-pandemic recovery, ports all over the world started to see a buildup of vessels and increasing wait times. So we used our methodology to take a closer look at shipping times, specifically looking at port pairs, where something is coming from, coupled with where it is going, and calculating the typical travel times for these voyages.
We then compared those to pre-pandemic levels to get a sense of extra delays. So we created measures of port congestion and delays in sea transport for every port all around the world. And we discovered some interesting patterns. We saw a discernible increase in global average port delays amounting to almost 2 days in February 2022. We estimate that these delays represent a staggering 25% increase in average shipping times across the globe.
The world effectively became a significantly more distant place when it comes to delivering goods over the seas. However, we also found substantial geographical differences, with delays in some major economies clearly standing out. So why the delays? In principle, both demand and supply could be driving them.
First, the pandemic caused a shift in how we spend. In a short period of time, the demand for contact-intensive services dropped and the demand for goods skyrocketed, and most of those goods arrived to us by boat. Combined the greater demand for goods with COVID-driven capacity constraints at ports, and we have a recipe for a crunch.
The importance of these two factors is vastly diverse across ports around the world. For many, longer delays come hand in hand with increased trade volumes, a sign that booming demand plays a key role. In some cases, however, we see delays even though trade volumes are lower than before the pandemic. This is a likely symptom of supply constraints that go beyond infrastructure capacity and possibly reflect other bottlenecks, such as labor shortages, as economies continue to grapple with the virus.
There is intense discussion about elevated inflation and its link to supply disruptions, including port congestion. Our analysis reveals that troubleshooting this global clogging requires tailored solutions, recognizing the different drivers of delays in different parts of the world.
More generally, what our study provides is a factual basis for this conversation, a starting point to measure and compare bottlenecks globally as we rebuild our trade networks and revitalize our economies.